Nityanandam, welcome to this special edition of NTV News from Dhyanapeetam Ashram here in Bidadi. It's February 25th, 2011. We continue to bring you news about the continuing harassment by the CID towards Swamiji and Dhyanapeetam. A large group of devotees and disciples did a peaceful protest in front of the police station in Bidadi for the release of the ashramites who are being held illegally. During the protest, some of our ashramites were pushed around and verbally abused. In a news report in Deccan Herald, it was falsely reported, as usual, that the ashramites were arrested for spiriting away Ma Nitya Sadananda, who the CID had come to interrogate. The real story is that Ma Nitya Sadananda has been away from Bidadi Ashram for a couple of months for medical treatment. While the CID was coming into the campus yesterday, one of our lady sannyasin was leaving the ashram to go to the city for buying supplies for the ashram. The senior sannyasin later came back to the ashram after finishing her work. Without verifying facts, as always, Deccan Herald failed to investigate or inquire at the ashram before publishing wrong and false information. We are receiving a lot of emails of support from our ashrams, temples and centers all around the world. Thousands of devotees are coming together to fight against this atrocity that is being continuously done on Paramahamsa Nityananda and his ashramites and devotees. We have a report for you from our Vedic temple in San Jose, California, USA.
Stop religious persecution!
We will not tolerate any harassment or abusal illegally towards Dhyanapeetam. Stop now.
Stop atrocities against Nityananda Dhyanapeetam now.
People are entitled to religious freedom.
Enough is enough.
Stop this injustice. Give us a break.
We want justice.
Enough is enough.
Nityanandam Dasharathi, you must have heard this morning's news that innocent ashramites from Swami Nityananda's ashram have been arrested for no reason, with not even an FIR. What do you think about that?
Let me tell you, I'm really appalled, and I cannot say whether I should smile or cry about this, because I heard that it is about obstruction of justice. First you have to have justice, then you can have obstruction. If you observe in this whole case, justice is nowhere to be seen. I mean, there is no precedent where you can arrest people without an FIR. I do not know where there is a legal or justice precedence for such kind of things to happen. I mean, it's totally bizarre, and it's like we are going back to Stone Age, and there is no legal system in such a big one of the biggest democracies in the world. I just can't believe it. I mean, what is Swamiji trying to do? I mean, think about this. From March 2nd, he's going to have a global peace initiative, where he's trying to reduce the crimes, man-made and natural calamities, where man is making calamities, and he's trying by intense meditation with people, 10,000 people sitting all over the world together at a certain time, and sending that positive energy to bring down the crime. And if he's doing that, and what are you doing to him? I mean, to him and Dhyanapeetam, trying to arrest people? Does it even make sense? Just something is completely topsy-turvy in your heads. So go ahead and check it, please.
Nityanandam, it's very sad news to hear that this injustice is continuing. You know, how much longer are they going to continue to try to just put people in jail or arrest them for no legitimate reason, with no evidence, with no legal documents? This is just ridiculous. It's about time it came to a stop.
Nityanandam, I'm really disturbed right now and very upset. I don't know what is going on with the devotees, the disciples, the satsangis of Swamiji at this point. We are really upset, and emotionally we are feeling very much down. We feel very offended right now. I really don't understand one thing. What Swamiji has done wrong to this world? That he is bringing peace, he is offering all the support, compassion, and all the love and this beautiful program to reduce the crime rate in this world, to bring the higher consciousness to this world and help the humanity. But Swamiji has nothing done anything illegal, nothing at all. Why people don't understand this very clearly and accept the truth and let him set free and let the devotees and disciples be free? Let us do what we want to do in this world, which is just practicing spirituality, bringing peace and spreading love to the humanity, nothing else. So please, see to this, see the fact and work on it. Stand up for yourself, stand up for the truth, and stand up for love and compassion, and spread it all over the world. Nityananda.
I am totally puzzled. I honestly don't understand why people are getting arrested. This is a group and community preaching love, compassion, peace, oneness with the world, and instead people are getting arrested. This is totally bizarre. Everybody I know, and I've been part of the Sangha for so many years, is, forget law-abiding, totally loving, compassionate, kind and helpful. So this is really weird that people are not entitled to practice. And practice what? Practicing love for humanity. This is complete religious persecution. It needs to stop. Come on, people need to stand up for the truth. It's ridiculous. It just has to stop. Why can't people practice what they want? Which is love, peace and totally social, you know, compassionate stuff. I don't know why antisocial elements are popping into stuff which is totally social, loving, kind and peaceful. People need to realize what's going on, wake up, stand up and let people practice and have religious freedom to practice what they believe in. Thank you.
We also have a report for you from Guadalupe, where devotees did a silent meditation and chanted the Guru Mantra. Support satsangs are also being held in the island. Also, reports are pouring in from Philadelphia and also from Phoenix in the United States. That's the update for now. Swamiji will be holding a press conference today afternoon at 2 p.m., where he will be answering questions from the press and revealing new information about the recent happenings at the ashram. Tune in to NTV at 2 p.m. Indian Standard Time for the press meet. Nityanandam.